Hey guys, it's 2019, it's a new year, it's springtime right now, and you know what that means? That means it's time for a brand new bike. So this year I got a new 2018 Factor 02 disc, SRAM Red E-Tap, 11-speed HRD hydro brakes, Zip 404 Firecrest disc brake wheels, Continental Grand Prix 5000 tires, and we've got the lip keel blade carbon 2 pedals. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started opening the unboxing, okay? Alright guys, as you can see, this is the AG2R blue color, size 54. Factor sets their bikes with a chassis setup, which means you get the seat post, you get the innovative bar and stem assembly, you can choose between sizes of the sizes of width and also the length of the stem. And on a seat post, you get two options. You get the zero setback, and then you also get a 25 millimeter setback. I decided to go with the 25 millimeter setback. Okay, so inside the box, you get pretty much the bar tape comes with it. You get a ceramic speed bottom bracket. The headset is also ceramic speed. You get the carbon paste. You also get a mount for your Garmin for the integrated bar and stem assembly. And I'll do a little bit more close-up pictures. And then when I have it mounted, I'll put on my Garmin so y'all can see that also. Okay? All right. And it also comes with a AG2R sticker if you want to install that. Okay, so for a saddle, I decided to go with the Physique Arione R1 carbon rails. And on that, I went with the record size. When I first heard about blacking, I was a little hesitant about what they meant by their own supplied parts. I never heard of blacking before I started looking and investigating into Factor. And so blacking is pretty much their own in-house brand, just kind of like Pinarello has Mose and Jaguar parts. C-Post is very light, very nicely made. I love the hand, how they have the little detailing of the gloss black just right on top of the matte blacks. It's very, very nice looking. And like I said, I'll take some more closer shots of the parts so y'all can get a little bit better look at what we're looking at here. All right, let's get this baby unwrapped so we can see what we got here. So Factor has a few colors to choose from. They have burnt orange, AG2R, blue of course. They also have stealth black, and then a black to look at a turquoise. And a couple of other special order colors. They also have two Roman Bardet colors available as well. They had a white pearl with blue lettering, and then they also had a silver with black lettering. I decided to go with this color because it was my favorite. it's just the most striking to me of all the colors that they had to choose from. Okay, so here I've got pretty much everything unwrapped. Just to go over a couple of specs, the tires and wheels. Wheels are Zip 404 Firecrest disc wheels with the Continental Grand Prix 5000 tires. I love how the new Zip 404s have the embossed 404 on the wheels instead of having the 404 sticker. Gives it a much more cleaner look, much more higher end look, and looks great. So bottle cages, I went with the Elite Custom Race in matte black. Pedals, Keel Blade 2 carbon in the Pro Team colorway. Saddle is going to be the Physique Arione R1 carbon with the carbon rails. And then here's the detailing on the seat posts where the matte black and the gloss black come together. Looks really nice. You got the dongle here for updates, and then your charging cords, charger, and then the adapters for your chargers. And I love how SRAM gives you the bleed kit with the group set. So the bleed kit comes with the syringes to bleed, and then also your brake fluid. Also comes with the plugs that you insert into the calipers while you're doing the bleed process. With the Zip wheels, you get some valve extenders, and you also get the skewers and the end caps for either rim brake or the through axle for your disc brakes. And here is the supplied black ink Garmin mount. Okay guys, so the bike is pretty much assembled. And I just want to get a closer look at the details for y'all. So crank set, I went with the compact 5034. Crank length is 172.5. On the rear, I went with the 1132 cassette and the Y-Fly mid-cage rear derailleur. The seat stays are super, super thin. Looks great, great for comfort. And here's the detailing on the seat posts with the black ink logoing, and then also the 25 millimeter setback. The R1 Arione looks really awesome on this bike. It is by far my favorite saddle. And we've got some detailing here down at the bottom of the down tube near the bottom bracket with the British flag on it. Here's a closer look at the Garmin mount, and with the white finishing tape at the end of the bar tape. Gives it a nice little touch.
and then the black ink bar and stem combo has your black ink logo on there, and also a little bit of the gloss paint just to give it a little bit of contrast from your matte black. And we've got the ceramic speed headset. Down here we have the ceramic speed bottom bracket. And the nice detailing with the British flag. I actually like the rotors on the last ETAP HRD group instead more than I do like the new rotors. A little bit more skeletonized versus that saw blade looking rotor insert. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching. I hope you liked the video and I hope it was informative. Please like, subscribe, and hope to see you soon with the bike on the road. One last thing before I put the bike on the road. The chainstay did not come with the protective film on the chainstay. So I've got my local paint protection company that's going to cut me a piece of protective film, paint protection. So I'm going to apply that, and then I'm also going to apply it to the bottom of the main down tube before I should take it on the road. Alright guys, thank you again. Please like and subscribe. Thank you.